Good evening, everyone. Welcome once again on behalf of Ambassadors of Mediation and Madhyam International Council for Dispute Resolution to the series Agree to Disagree to our guests of honor, the participants, and our viewers of Madhyam TV. Today is the fifth episode in the series of the table debate with the topic Online Mediation is Superfluous, which we will be incidentally discussing online. It is my proud honor and privilege to welcome our guest of honor, Ms. Veena Rally. Veena Mann, an ACE international mediator, trainer, organizing secretary, Samadhan, Delhi High Court Mediation and Conciliation Center. She has done advanced training of trainers at S.J. Quinney College of Law and Strauss Institute of Dispute Resolution, Pepperdine University, both in USA, and another advanced mediation masterclass from SIMC Singapore. She is an accredited mediator with CIR London and SIMI Singapore. She has, with her grit and hard work, taken Samadhan to new heights with numerous trainings undertaken not only for lawyers, but judicial officers to Pan India. She is truly inspirational and modesty personified, having handled more than 1,000 mediations. She is known for her Midas touch. Welcome to all our participants today evening too. They are all best established lawyers and trained mediators in their respective cities. Thanks again to all the viewers of Madhyam TV. We promise to keep bringing more of such thought-provoking programs. There are, for the new viewers, just a recap of the program. There are two teams with two participants in each team. They will be first giving a team as a together team will be speaking for the motion before the house in a span of say 3 minutes. There will be a warning bell at 2 minutes and then another at 3 minutes. Thereafter, the floor will be taken over by our guest of honor who will, after the views of the participants, will randomly ask questions each to the participants and a follow-up question if required in her discretion. The teams then in reverse order will get a chance to give rebuttal to the opposite team. And in the end, our guest of honor will summarize the debate. Let me introduce the teams to the topic, online mediation is superfluous. Team A for the motion has Ms. Neelmani Gandhi. Ms. Gandhi is founder of Susamvad, a dispute resolution center in Maharashtra. She is a lawyer for over 3 decades and an accredited mediator, ADR, ODR, and SIMI, besides having done her training from MCPC. She is joined by Mr. Ramdas. Mr. Ramdas was called to the bar in 1994. He is primarily based in Chennai and received mediation training from the Tamil Nadu Mediation and Conciliation Center in 2008. Team B, who is speaking against the motion, has Mr. Atul Batra, who is the managing partner of Uniserv Law Offices, New Delhi, a practicing lawyer for over 3 decades, trained mediator since 2006 by Samadhan, and has done training from Strauss Institute for Dispute Resolution, Pepperdine University, USA. Mr. Batra also is running 2 charitable organizations, Chirag, working with pediatric cancer, and another one, Uniserv Foundation, which is working on child education and food for hungry. Very noble cause indeed. He is joined with his team, Ekta Behel, a corporate transactional lawyer, partner with Samvad Partner, heading the Hyderabad office. She is a trained mediator and negotiator. Welcome everyone. Please, I would request Ms. Veena Rally, our guest of honor, to invite the teams. Please, ma'am.
Thank you, Pooja. Very interesting topic. Online mediation is superfluous. What are your views, Neelmani, on this?
Thank you, Veena, ma'am. I'm going to speak about the online mediation is superfluous. Of course, the process of online mediation is on a digital platform. So we use electronic, internet, technology, obviously. This is not available to every citizens of our country. Majority of our Indian population reside in rural areas, whereas internet, mobile connectivity has yet to reach. again this mechanism which has two concerns, because the types of disputes or online mediation we do deal with, one is which arises in a cyberspace and the other that arises offline, so which has a demand urgently of designing efficient mechanism for resolving disputes with the help of internet. Again, that's a problem with Pan India because it has not yet reached to the remotest area of our country. As the mediation is conducted on a virtual medium, the questions of data and information security becomes a prime question, because mediation is totally confidential process, so privacy is of course of a matter. For me, it is of a immense importance. So also lack of proper infrastructure and technology, the efficiency of the decision which is taken online, that also is of a issue which has to be resolved very clearly and clarifiedly. Only those people are able to take the benefit who are digitally literate and have access to suitable devices. So not only that, the steps of government are lacking to setting up the environment for the online disputes. In addition to this, inadequate support and implementation of available resources are also of a concern. Why and how I'm justifying this is very important, because face-to-face communication is instantaneous, which comes from true intention from the bottom of heart, whereas electronic communication is acronymous. Empathy, where we in mediation, empathy is of importance. If it is showcased, then matters are resolved very easily and quickly. So when we say online mediation is a quick resolution, I do see it very opposite, because empathy can be showcased only on a face-to-face communication. So the question of connections and the trust building, confidentiality, that does not guarantee in online mediation. So in a conclusion, I would like to say that online electronic communication in ODR, that is online dispute resolution, is no substitute for the face-to-face conversations, and to promote its importance to the larger masses of the public. Thank you, Veena.
Thank you, Nilmani. What are your views, Ramdas, on this?
I am for the motion that the online mediation is superfluous. I have 3 points to justify my stand on that. The first one is the virtual platform is technology dependent. Secondly, I feel that the virtual medium is far less engaging than the physical form of mediation. Thirdly, that there is a lack of effective control over the process itself, because of the over dependence on the technology. Coming to the first point, it is technology dependent, as pointed out earlier. Even people who are tech savvy sometimes find it difficult to cope with the advanced techniques that are required to participate in a virtual platform. And in a country like us, where most of the litigants are from rural background, particularly from, since I am from Chennai, I can relate to that in most cases. People do have mobiles, but internet connection is a premium. And we have issues like connectivity, network problem, and bandwidth problems. You know, even assuming that you are able to connect yourself, you are technically sound, but if you are not having sufficient backup in terms of connectivity, network, and bandwidth, it is difficult for even a tech savvy person to conduct a meeting on a virtual platform. And more importantly, people do not have much trust, particularly people who are not completely comfortable with the technology, find it difficult to accept or to relate, and they are not able to adapt themselves to the technical aspects of a virtual meeting. Secondly, the virtual platform, I feel, is less engaging, because in a physical meeting, you are able to develop an easy rapport with the participant. You are face to face. You can observe them. You are able to make eye contact. You can observe their body language. And you know, in a virtual platform, we are unable to create a rapport with the participant, and that itself is a big handicap for a person to conduct to establish the relationship with the participants, and the dynamics of a physical meeting is lost in a virtual platform. And particularly in terms of reading the body language, we are not able to understand, we are not able to empathize with them, and also in issues like, you know, venting their anger or confronting their concerns and understanding their concerns and confronting the issues that they face. It is easier done in a physical meeting than in a virtual platform. And more importantly, the mediator is able to develop a kind of trust with the parties in a physical meeting than in a virtual platform, because though we say that, you know, all the parties are together in a room, the ambience is different. A mediator is sitting in the comforts of his office maybe, but the party may be at home, and there will be, obviously, we don't have any control over their environment. And the third aspect is the effective control of the mechanism. In a room where we have the parties face to face, the entire environment there is controlled by the mediator. He's able to control the behavior as well as the do's and don'ts of a mediation process. But in a virtual platform, there are so many distractions. You know, people who may be sitting in the comforts of their home, they may be watching their mobiles, they may be texting messages, or there will be other distractions like some noise coming from outside, or even a third party entering into the place where the mediation is being held, or the place from where the party is participating. So it becomes obviously difficult for a person to maintain or give a constant attention to what is happening in a virtual meeting. And
I think you have given good inputs. Let me just ask now, Ekta, you are going to speak against the motion. What are your views on this, Ekta?
Thank you so much, Veena. Yes, I'll be speaking against the motion that online mediation is superfluous. You know, the start, I'd like to say, you know, life is not constant. But one of the constants in life is actually that there is change. And online mediation has actually brought about this a sea of change in how we look at mediation and how we adopt technology and other forms of communication to look at mediation. Even how we look at, you know, our own interpersonal, how do we connect, how do we relate, how do we talk to each other. In fact, while looking at the reasons why we're against the motion, there are several reasons. I will focus on just three of them, and some of the other reasons my teammate Atul will speak on as well. So the three issues that I will be speaking on, the three reasons I'll speak on, is that online mediation or online form of communication actually effectively results in better communication. The second thing is that given how we look at technology, we can actually have more secure and more private ways of communicating with each other. The third thing is, let's not leave the environment out of the equation, but the entire process of moving virtual also has an environmental impact, and a positive environmental impact. Coming to the first issue, which is that, you know, we look at, you know, online or virtual communication to be an effective and a better way of communication. You know, we've heard a lot about that, you know, you have to have a face-to-face connect, and that is what, you know, really brings about communication. I think we should not forget the fact that for a large part, and many, many years ago, the form of communication that people would relate to each other was in the form of letters. Let's not even talk about technology, it was letters.
we could really feel emotions, and I'm talking about feel emotions through the words that was expressed, and that was a written word that was expressed. And today, again, let us not forget, the world is very differently connected today. You know, everybody, and we connect emotionally, virtually. Technology has invaded our homes. We've adapted to it. You know, we talk to family, friends, you know, video calls is the norm. I mean, you know, it's not about the COVID scenario which has brought technology homes. It was even before that. Text messages, we constantly communicate with each other. In fact, picking up the phone and calling or meeting somebody over lunch, you know, is rarer than wishing somebody a happy birthday over a WhatsApp message. Difficult conversations, and this is something which has been said that, you know, from time and again, when you have difficult conversations, sometimes the best way to communicate is through words, is not being in front of the person. And technology and the virtual world have given us a platform to do that, where we can speak to another person without being confrontational. Okay, we can also see that sometimes we have power plays, and what the virtual world puts a screen before us. So when we participate in communication, or we communicate in a mediation, it is more egalitarian. It balances issues out. So then, you know, moving on to security and privacy, doctors have moved online. You have treatment of patients online, and doctors are bound by the law, and they look at regulation day in and day out. So if they are people who can move and treat patients online with secure systems, and we have new platforms today, those platforms are something even we could adopt, and we are adopting. So we are seeing newer platforms around as well.
Let us see, Ekta, what has Atul to add to what you have said? Atul, over to you, please.
I am supporting Ekta on against the motion. Online system is super obvious. I don't know why this debate is there at all. Even prior to this so-called online system, when we were in the physical format, we were doing online mediations. We were connecting with parties in a video conferencing room set up by the centers, and communicating with the parties abroad at the same time. There are a lot many benefits of online mediation. But before that, I touch upon the benefits of an online mediation. I would like to say, what is it that we are looking forward to? Are we not looking forward to efficiency? Does the technology not bring in efficiency? If tomorrow's the technology brings in some benefits to our judicial system, if tomorrow's it brings in certain benefits to our mediation process, ADR, ODR processes, why should we not adopt to the same? Technology from typewriters, when I started my career, we moved on to computers. The acceptability of the older advocates was a little on the lower side. But today, my father, who's 90 years of age, practices law still, is using a smartphone to communicate. So where is the problem of technology? I don't understand. And let us see the benefits of mediation on an online platform. It negates travel time. You don't have to travel. You are at the comfort zone of your office, home, or wherever you are. It avoids the excuses of an advocate or a litigant to be stuck up in a court or stuck up in a traffic. You can schedule a meeting prior or post your process time schedule. So within a minute, you can be in a different meeting in a different zone on the technology platform. And tomorrow's world, the businesses are being conducted online. Like my fellow speaker said, the doctors are doing it. The business people are doing it. So why should not the judicial system, why should not the ADR system also adopt this technology to its benefit? And in certain cases, like a matrimonial dispute, the people are reluctant to face each other. So this online platform is one of the modes where this online this facing each other can be avoided. In conclusion, I would say that it helps in saving time, money, infrastructure costs of the center, and brings in certainty in a lot of respects.
Right, Atul, it is really very interesting to know your views. But I would like to know now from Ekta, please tell me, as we all know that confidentiality is at the core of mediation. It's the vital ingredient to ensure that parties voluntarily enter into the process of mediation, and we as mediators enable them to participate effectively and successfully. But do you think confidentiality is a casualty in online mediation? Just let me know your views on this.
I totally disagree with that, because if you look at prying eyes, you know, whether you look at prying eyes was there even before technology. And if you look at sharing of information, and I gave the example of doctors as a perfect example, because doctors by law are required to maintain confidentiality, are by law required to ensure that everything is taking place in secrecy. There cannot be any data leakage. So there is a huge legal obligation that's placed on doctors. And doctors, especially through telemedicine, are adopting technology. So the systems that we have today, especially because of security protocols that are being evolved, which have evolved over the years and which are still evolving, we're seeing better protection of data. We are seeing how screens are monitored, how conversations take place. I think confidentiality through technical advances is something that is at the heart of online mediation. And I think we could adapt to that, especially if doctors can do it, why should we be far behind?
Thank you, it's very insightful, really enriching for us also. Atul, over to you. I just want to know from you, one of the concerns in mediation is to have the right decision maker on the negotiation table. One of the concerns in mediation is to have the right decision maker on the negotiation table, have participation of the person of authority to decide before you as a mediator. Absence of the decision maker is a source of impasse, as we know. How does online mediation help us to handle such impasse?
It doesn't help us, but it doesn't have any disqualification to it. It's the same process. You ask a party whether are you the decision maker, are you the authorized representative, are you duly authorized by the resolution of a company? Because even in the physical format, sometimes AR is representing and the directors are sitting somewhere outside in some different country.
Yes.
It's a similar thing which is happening here. All that a mediator has to follow his process, which he was following it in the physical format.
So Atul, if I understand from you, in this process of online mediation, the decision maker can come out of his that comfort zone wherever he's sitting, online, and he can be before you, and it becomes easy to handle that impasse. This is what I think you're saying.
Yes. This is one of the aspects of benefits of the online mediation process.
Neelmani, just let me know, what are your views? In mediation, emotions play an important role in conflict resolution, and we as mediators need to use all techniques for containing, transforming, and dissolving conflict. How can one acknowledge and then handle emotions digitally? How can one handle emotions online? That's a basic question I want to know from you. Is it similar to handling emotions offline? Do you think online mediation questions the efficacy of the process while dealing with emotions?
Yes, I totally agree that the online mediation does not work as an alternate mechanism for the handling emotion, especially because offline mediation, that is face-to-face mediation, of course, gives a lots of or a tremendous value to the empathy, to the human interaction and communication. And that's what I feel that on an online mediation, it is missing. Because in online mediation, there is a lack of human interaction. We have experiencing that there is a internet connectivity disturbances are there. No availability many time is there. So other than that, lack of literacy, how to use the devices, how to use online platform. So again, question of a confidentiality. And in such these scenarios, in these lacking facilities, I feel handling emotion is not that effective as I am expressing that it is effective in a face-to-face mediation. Because there also, while dealing with the emotions and handling with the scenario, emotional scenarios or the mindsets of the litigants, again, trust, confidence, and that rapport has to be built up between the parties. So when you are sitting personally in a physical form, that's very easy for handling all such scenarios. You can send them to a different room, or you can offer a cup of tea and coffee. Here in this online mediation, you cannot do. You just ask them to do on their own. But I think that will not be helpful, and that's not as effective as it is on an offline mediation.
Ramdas, just let me know, the key point in mediation is to gain trust of the party. When parties feel at ease, they feel they are heard and understood. Can we leave it up to the parties to decide how they prefer to meet, face to face or online? What if one party is comfortable face to face and other does not want to move outside the comfort of one's home or office? Can you see a hybrid system working in mediation, where face-to-face meetings are combined with online tools? Can we have an overall efficient and effective process by combining both face-to-face and online mediation?
Yeah, we do. There is a possibility of having such an arrangement. Particularly, I feel that in cases where personal issues are involved, it is better to have physical meeting, because parties are able to express their emotions. And we as mediators are also able to empathize with their with them, and to relate and understand their concerns, and also to confront the emotions. But in a purely commercial transaction, a party can always opt for a virtual platform, because it doesn't involve emotions. It only involves more particularly the business concerns, and their monetary aspects of the transactions alone are dealt with. So in such cases, I think we can offer in family issues, like in family disputes, or in cases where there is emotional aspects are involved, like say adoption cases, where the custody of the child is an issue. Emotions play a larger role. So in such cases, we can always advise for a physical meeting, because there we will be able to interact with them on a personal level and resolve the matter in a better manner than in a virtual platform.
Thank you, Ramdas. Thank you. Now, Ekta, over to you. Would you like to say something in rebuttal of the motion?
Thanks, Veena. Yes, I would. In fact, I would like to respond to a couple of things that Ramda said. And the first thing is, he said that, online mediation or online communication is far less engaging. So, as an example, I'll give it. I met my husband virtually. We dated virtually. A large part of our, even post-marriage, we lived apart for a long time, so we communicated virtually. And I can tell you that our conversations were not any less engaging than they are when we are in the same room. Having said that, I think engaging conversations is about how we make them. And if you see, you hear grandparents talk virtually with each other, with grandchildren on a FaceTime or in a Zoom call, they're as engaging as if the child would sit next to you. So about how to make conversations engaging, I think the initial hurdle is getting comfortable with the technology. I think once you're comfortable with it, you can make it as engaging as you want. The second thing is on, which Ramdas mentioned, that there's a digital dependence and there's a lack of digital penetration, and also the fact that there's lack of effective control. The beauty of mediation is the process, the openness of the process. It's about how the parties can define how they would like the process to be. It is about how the mediator can control the tools within them. You can go as low tech or as high tech as you want. You're not limited by the fact that I need to have the most high end platforms. Mediations can be conducted even through a simple phone call. And today, almost everybody, even in rural India, all four of us have a basic telephone. And the assumption is again that, mediation has to happen only through personal devices. It's not necessary to do so. It's technology. Technology is about how you make it efficient. You could have centers we can evolve because situations around us are evolving, so we can evolve with them. And an example of that is if you look at the youth of today, or the children of today, they communicate far more effectively through electronic means than they do face-to-face. They get it. I think it's about time that we should do. Thank you.
Atul, what are your views in Dipadal on this?
I would like to rebut what Deepmani ma'am had to say. She had raised the issue of technology, rural areas, connectivity, data and security, inadequate support, empathy, trust. The first four points are actually, it's a question just of time. You throw, make it viable for a business house, they will enter into each and every household and sell their data. And why are we even talking about it again? Because you find, you go to the rural areas, the boys and girls are actually watching full-fledged movies on their mobiles. So where is the connectivity issue? And the issue of empathy and the body language are all superfluous. What constitutes the body language? It's about some percentage, a minimal percentage of the spoken words. A majority of it is the tone in which they have spoken. And a further larger majority is the body, rest of the body language. And amongst the rest of the body language, it is the facial expressions which you can actually see in a virtual world. You can see it. It's only the rest of the body that's missing as to what is missing. And one of our co-mediators, Mandira Mitra, in the south of India, she narrated an incident that she was teaching some call center people, and one of the boys there had to stay in a call center, not even on a video thing. My smile reaches the person on the other side through my voice. So see the power of communication. And here we are talking of a video court, a video mediation where we can see each other as good as if we are sitting side by side. So that's what...
Thank you, Atul. Thank you for this. Thank you for your views. Over to Neelmani. What are your views in rebuttal?
Yeah, I appreciate the views of Atulji. But even I have some views in rebuttal with the Atulji as well as Ekta too. First, I would come to Ekta. Ekta said she can speak and she can see her husband and there is a quite nice connectivity between us. We can maintain our communication healthy in such a way. I do agree with that. But where is the emotional touch? In a face-to-face communication, what emotional touch you express or you showcase, that is totally absence in the online communication. For giving example, my daughter is in Germany. I do speak to her on an online, on a WhatsApp or video call. But even then she feels, Mama, I want to hug you when we like come to India. So that's what I say, that's emotional touch is really, it's always missing. And that a small touch also can resolve mediation. And that opportunity we do not get in online mediation. Again, I come back to the cybersecurity when it was told during the argument or advocating the online mediation. There are lots of cases we have heard about the internet hacking or your account hacking. So in that case, due to lack of knowledge of a technology or cybersecurity also, there are lots of issues which have occurred. And in that scenario, this is happening in today's scenario with all of us. Even we are educated well. We are educated technology, we are tech savvy. Then also many of us educated, trained person, they do put into the trap of cybersecurity. So in that way, under the cybersecurity, under the threat of data privacy, there is a confidentiality is of a high importance. Privacy of person's rights are at the stake. So that cannot be compromised. And in such scenario, when I say privacy, confidentiality, in that scenario, of course, your private privacy cannot be harmed and cannot be compromised. So I do not agree with Atul and Ekta.
Thank you, Neelmani, for sharing your views. Over to Ramdas. What have you to say?
Yeah, Ekta was saying that, you know, she had met her husband online and they had a very engaging conversation which ultimately led to their marriage. But see, in a litigation mode, people don't like to engage as such, even on even when it comes to physical meetings. It takes a lot of coercing from our part and from the part of the advocates to make parties sit. But even in a virtual platform, particularly when you are in a confrontation mood, you know, it is easy for a person to just switch off and walk away, because we don't have control over their over what they do. So that as such, you know, makes it less engaging, and you are unable to create a physical rapport with the party and make them comfortable. So these are things which can the personal, the interactive meetings give a better scope for us to express, to make them at ease, and also to engage them to participate in the meeting. And the other aspect is they were talking about the technology being available to people. The kids are watching movies. Even in villages, watching movies is a different aspect. When it comes to actually using the technology for a virtual meeting, one has to know the nitty-gritty of the technology, and that doesn't come easy. It requires a lot of skill. And as you get old, you have litigants who are not even able, they can attend calls, and maybe they can. Do a WhatsApp chat, or they can do a video call, but not when it comes to a meeting of this stage, where you know they have to actually put forth their case and express their viewpoint. That comes that doesn't come easy, and it takes, as Atulji said, it takes a lot of time. So naturally, you know, it is a it requires a lot of grooming and a lot of sessions to make people actually comfortable to such virtual platforms. And the other aspect is, you know, the dynamics of a physical meeting can never be achieved in a virtual platform.
Thank you, Ramdas. And I must say, it is really very interesting to know everybody's views on this, on the topic of the day. Online mediation is superfluous. I just would like to share my views also on this. You know, in today's time, technology has become part of everybody's life, whether you talk about a small child or an old person. Like Atul shared with us that even his father is very much aware about the technology and he's using a smartphone. Particularly, the outbreak of this COVID-19 has brought various changes in lifestyle of the public and brought various restrictions as well. Restrictions in the shape of the movement of the parties, of the people moving out of their houses. So to contain the curve of virus, the court worked on minimal basis. During these tough times, a transformative change was envisaged even in dispute redressal mechanism. Though people have begun to receive vaccine, but experts say pandemic still persists. And we have a long road ahead, and it will take time for vaccine to have pronounced effect. So it is imperative to ensure to obtain requisite skills, this is what I feel, to set basically to prepare oneself and equip oneself and meet the changing demands. I'm also one of them. Even I did not know as much technology as I know today, but thanks to my family members and people around, because when you are put in that situation, I thought that I must know how to handle mediation, because I am a mediator. So time is now to achieve excellence in holding the process of mediation online. This is my view. Online mediation is a futuristic approach, and it is just as effective as traditional mediation, where the parties sit face to face and resolve their disputes. It is time, I think, that mediation reaches everybody's house without being restricted to distance or borders, and becomes more acceptable to people sitting at their homes. Because most of the times we saw mediations not taking place effectively because parties could not travel or could not reach to the office of the mediator or to the center where the mediator was sitting. So online mediation is definitely a step forward in making this world a better place for everyone till the situation changes and we feel safe to sit across the table to hold negotiations for the purposes of resolution of disputes. It saves time, energy, money, and encourages participation. More and more people can participate in this process and they can help themselves to resolve their disputes with the help of mediator. Of course, people are skeptic about confidentiality. That is a casualty, generally people feel, because you do not know whether only the party is sitting in the room or somebody else is also there, or there is any possibility of recording any proceedings by anyone. But this can also be handled by an experienced mediator by being vigilant, using mediation skills, because you have to keep yourself focused on the issues, look at the parties the way you are supposed to, just concentrate, be there. So even during online process, be there, use all your mediation skills, manage technology and reminding people about the adverse consequences in case of a breach. That will definitely help all of us as mediators to handle all aspects of mediation in such a way that the process moves smoothly and parties feel that they are in a very safe zone despite being online for the purposes of resolution of their disputes. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, Pooja, for giving me this opportunity.
Please, ma'am, thank you so much. It has been such an enriching episode this time, and especially more so, thank you to Atul, Ekta, Neelmani ji, and Ramdas ji, and the cherry on the top. This program would not have been this good, but for you, Veena ma'am. Thank you so much for taking out time. Thank you.